Hi everyone, so I'm here to do a requested video and I was highly requested to review the Sonia Kashuk Ion Dazzling Color 03 that came out for fall 2012, and it has 12 beautiful shadows, definitely fall inspired. You have a beautiful copper, a beautiful green, some beautiful purples, and some beautiful brown neutral shades as well. So this row here and this row here are definitely more of a frostier finish, and then we have the middle row here that are definitely more of a glitter shadow. So I will get into the swatches in a second. So I love that there is a open window here so you can see all of these shadows. I really like that. And this is also an instructional palette, so that means that there is a hidden drawer here and it has three separate looks. The first look is called Nude Shimmer and it is using more of the lighter shades in this palette. Look number two is Amethyst Allure, and it is using more of the purple shades in this palette. So it is more of an intense look. And then look number three is Emerald Amber Sparkle, which is using that beautiful copper that is probably my favorite color in this palette, and then that beautiful green. So what I like about these particular instructions is that it not only shows you how to achieve this eye look, but it also tells you the lip color that works best with this look and also the blush that works best with this look. So I really love that, and I just love the concept of this, which almost reminds me of the Too Faced palettes because they have these little cards that pop out and gives you instructions on how to achieve a couple looks as well. So I love this concept a little better because you're not going to lose any of these cards. So I love that. Okay, so on to the swatches, which is what you really want to know. So all of these colors are numbered, and you're probably not going to see that really nicely, but they are all numbered. So 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12. So these are all the swatches. This is number 1, which is the only highlight in this palette. I wish that they had mattes in this palette, but unfortunately they don't. And this is the glitter shadow in this palette. And then here we have this champagne-y shade, which is this color right here. And then we have this beautiful cranberry shade, which is this shade right here. And then the purple glitter, which is this one right here. And then we have that darker bluish purple right there, which is that color right there. Then my favorite color, the copper, right there. And then you have this greenish glitter, but it doesn't come out as green as you would expect it. And then we have the beautiful green right here. And then we have this beautiful chocolate brown. I love this color. There it is right there. Then you have this silver glitter, which is probably the least pigmented in this entire palette. And then we have the black shadow, which has some silver shimmer to it. So those are all of the colors. As you can see right there, these are all the glitter shadows, and I applied them dry, so you can see that they're not really all that pigmented dry. And definitely the darker shades are more pigmented than the rest. And then those are the lighter shades. So as much as I love the glitter shadows in this collection, you definitely have to use them wet or else there's going to be a lot of fallout. They're not going to be very pigmented. All you're going to get is glitter, and it's not going to give you the right effect. So I highly recommend using these shadows here wet. So getting a good foiling agent is definitely important. And I just use my All Natural Face Hydration Mist. And I showed you here using the purple glitter how the difference is. So this is the glitter shadow without anything, so it's just dry. And then here I applied it wet, so it's just the glitter shadow. nothing else. And then I apply the darker purple, and then on top of that, the purple glitter shadow. So you can see that there is a major difference, and that is why I say you definitely need to apply these wet, and you won't have any problems with fallout. So again, my only complaint is that there are no mattes. I wish that there was a matte highlight, a matte blending shade, and probably a darker matte shade for the outer V. But if you're an eyeshadow junkie like me, then you probably have some mattes in your collection that you can definitely use to get the desired look with this palette. And the formula of these shadows are definitely creamy and blendable, almost like the Too Faced shadows. I wouldn't say that they're as pigmented as the Too Faced shadows, but the blendability and the creaminess is definitely on par with the Too Faced shadows. If you like, you know, jewel tone shadows, then you're definitely gonna like this. If you like glitter shadows, then you're definitely gonna like this. But if you are more of a neutral type of gal, then I wouldn't really suggest this palette, because there are only just four neutrals in this palette, and then one of them is a glitter shadow. So really only three if you look at it that way. So then I wouldn't recommend it. But other than that, it's a fun palette. I use this a lot. I love, again, the glitter shadows to apply on top of my shadows. And not just the shadows in this palette. I've used the glitter shadows on top of other shadows that I have in my collection, and it just gives a really nice, cool effect. So I do have a tutorial with this palette that I had uploaded in my old channel, but I will upload it to my new channel so you can check out how these shadows look like and how they apply on the eyes. So I hope that this review was helpful. I believe that this palette cost $20, which for me personally I think is a little bit overpriced. Seeing that, you know, this is basically like a drugstore brand, and again, that there's no mattes in this palette, so, you know, I probably would only pay $15 for this palette. But, other than that, again, it's a great palette. So, I hope that this was helpful, and I will talk to you all in the next video. Bye, guys.